Yo, this is Elan and
Family Man here.
And you're listening to Mo Train's Tracks.
So tune in.
Yes.
Finish it.
My favorite song of all time is One Love, because One Love means more to me than any song I've ever heard on so many different levels.
Come on.
But I've never heard it played live. If you played One Love tonight, I'll be forever indebted to you, because I've never heard it. One Love! Yeah!
How the song goes. One good thing about music: when it hits, you feel no pain. And for the tens of thousands of people that were there during the Wailers set on Sunday afternoon at Lollapalooza, they certainly were feeling no pain at all. You know, it's not too often that someone gets to sit down with one of the most influential and legendary bands of all time, but at Lollapalooza, Motrain's Tracks had the honor and privilege to sit down with Aston family man Barrett, the original bassist and architect of Bob Marley and the Wailers, and also Elan, the new and amazing vocalist for the Wailers. There was something amazing going on in that crowd that day. No, it wasn't that cloud of smoke that was hovering over the crowd. It was the togetherness, the unity, the love that was going on and being shared through the music. If music was a church, the Wailers were holding mass that day. You know, it's an amazing feeling when tens of thousands of people were singing along with every word that Elan sung that day. And when I saw Family Man turn to Drummie Zeb and say one love, he turned down to us and smiled. The one drop drum set in, Elan looked down to us and pointed, and there it was, the first time that I had ever heard One Love live. An amazing, amazing time, and what better place than Lollapalooza 2007 with tens of thousands of new friends. You know, as we sat down backstage interviewing Family Man Barrett and Elan, it was like we had magnets on our bodies. From out of nowhere, people were drawn to the scene, drawn to a legend, and everyone wanted to hear what he had to say. Luckily, we were one of the few to be able to speak to them at Lollapalooza. I have to admit that there were certain times during the interview when I felt a bit like a fanboy, when Family Man Barrett started to recite his favorite lyrics that he had written from Bob Marley and the Wailers. It hit me hard. I couldn't believe that I was hearing these words, words that I had sung along to ever since I was a kid, every single summer. That half hour that we spent with Family Man and Elan is a half hour that I will never forget for the rest of my life. Make sure you check out the Wailers on tour because it'll be one show that you'll never ever forget. It is with my pleasure and true honor to bring you Aston Family Man Barrett and Elan, two members of the legendary Wailers. One love. We are sitting backstage with Mr. Family Man Barrett of Bob Marley and the Wailers. Thank you very, very much for being here. It's a true honor.
Yeah, man, it's a great pleasure to be here again in Chicago, you know. Partake with the Chicago blues.
Do you feel a certain responsibility of being a member, in my personal opinion, the most famous band, the most influential band of all time?
Yeah, man, we come together from the late 60s, you know, as singers and players of instruments. And our duty is to spread the message four corner of the earth, and thy will must be done by all means, no matter the crisis.
I've heard that you feel that you're destined to be continuing on the legacy of Bob Marley and the Wailers.
Well, yes, my legacy is also to keep the music going, because I am on the road officially from 1969 until 2007.
Wow.
Non-stop.
Non-stop. How does it feel?
It's good, you know, to be doing it before Bob, with Bob, and after Bob. Yeah, man.
You were the band director during the time with Bob and still now, correct?
Yes, before Bob, with Bob.
With Bob and
after
and
Bob.
After, right. What were your duties of being the band director? Did you write a lot of the songs? Were you doing the lyrics?
Well, between Bob, my brother, and I, we wrote like 11 tracks, and we registered 6 out of that. And I put the band together, not only as a band leader, but the musical producer and an arranger, bass player. And I play many other instruments too, and all the catalogs. I play rhythm guitar, lead block guitar, keyboards, and percussions.
You joined with the Upsetters, correct? Your brother and yourself were together, and then you were recruited to play with Bob.
Yeah, the first band was called, the first name was the Hippie Boys. And from the Hippie Boys to the Upsetters, and also Youths Professionals. That's what become Wailers International.
Well, you were working with Lee Perry, correct?
Yes.
His nickname was the Upsetter, correct? And then
he is the Upsetter, and we are the Upsetters.
How was the team? Was it a great team working together?
Yes, and that was the stadium where we started out with Bob Bunny and Peter.
Right.
And the first track we did was called "My Cup It's Run It Over."
One of my favorites. When you joined Peter, Bunny, and Bob. How was it getting acclimated to that new scene?
I know it's kind of jarring, but what we really do, we come together as singers and players of instruments, you know, and to carry out Jaja, the almighty message, and create the reggae music. And I am the architect of reggae. And as you know, that the reggae music is the heartbeat of the people. It's the universal language what carry that heavy message of roots, culture, and reality.
Well, speaking of the message, you say that rhythm is the message, correct? And the
yes,
heartbeat.
Drum is the heartbeat and the bass is the backbone. Yeah.
Your bass lines are some of the most recognizable bass lines in all of music. How do you take the spirit and passion of reggae and put it into your bass lines and into your music?
It's simply because I love singing, but I didn't practice. So when I play the bass, I sing baritone. So I give that melodic lines.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. I think it's a culmination, you say, of everyone working together. And your bass lines do hold together and just really gives it a great overall feeling of the music.
So true, my man. So true.
When you were with Bob Marley and the Wailers, reggae music primarily was in Jamaica, but you brought it together as a global consciousness of reggae music.
Yeah. The, in Jamaica, the first music, when it get, you know, constructed, it was called ska, and it go from ska to rock steady.
Rock steady, okay.
And I bring it to be reggae.
How was the influence of ska in your music?
Well, the reggae music consists of all different cultures of music. It got funk, it got soul, rhythm and blues, and of course some of the Chicago blues there.
Right.
And it's very jazzy.
When Al Anderson joined the band, didn't he bring a blues influence to the Wailers?
From 1974.
Yes.
Yes.
What are your thoughts on Bob Marley being a prophet?
Yes, we all are prophets of lyrics and we are musicians of the, we call the archangels.
There's so many different messages with the Wailers. Love. Unity. What do you feel the main message of Bob Marley and the Wailers? What do you feel that it has been?
It's to keep all nations, especially the young people, in line so they don't walk on the wild side.
You don't think they walk on the wild side?
Keep it a straight line. Positively.
When I spoke with Ziggy Marley, I spoke with him at Bonnaroo. We were talking about how he feels that he was on a quest for the truth. And he felt that it wasn't through religion, through politics, but he feels that love is the truth. What have you found to be the truth in your life and in your music?
Well, we know there's a lot of errors globally, you know, near and far, home and abroad. And that's why we choose to do the positive thing. And make songs like the Rastaman vibration is positive. And we always talk about what is taking place on earth in our lifetime. And how, you know, politics is the global issues. things like that.
What's your favorite song out of your whole Bob Marley and Wailers catalog? What song means the most to you?
I tell you, man, there are so many. But I gave it the first one. We will be forever.
Loving
Jah. Loving Jah.
Beautiful. Your life is following.
Yes.
Preaching the word of Jah.
Yes, the gospel, musically.
This year is year 2000 of the Rastafarian calendar, isn't it? Didn't they say that this year is supposed to be the return of the Almighty?
Oh, yeah, the year 2007. Year. We officially just reached the year 2000. You know, in the west side, the calendar is like 7 years ahead. It's like daylight saving time, you know.
Right. Yeah. But with reaching the year 2007, didn't they say that the Almighty was supposed to be returning in the year 2000 in the Rastafarian calendar?
Yes, they all got 7 years to prepare. And Rasta is in the heart, you know, of the true Rasta man for sure. I do have a lot of that little thing taking part, like the good, the bad, and the indifferences.
Right. Yeah. Everyone knows the serious and social influences that your band has on the world.
Yes.
But it couldn't have been all serious. What are some funny moments that you remember from your days on the road with Bob Marley and the Wailers?
Well, it's good to hear people talk all over the world. Oh, we changed their lives. They thank us for bringing the message. They even named their kids after us and things like that.
Yeah.
You know? And young people who could not come to the show when Bob was alive, so they were underage, they are coming today. And even young people who born after the passing of Bob take on to the message and the music just the same.
The message is still the same. From back in the 70s, back in the 60s, to the 2007, the message is still the same.
Just the same.
Still the same.
The reggae music, it's for all age and all time. It's for past, present, and future. And it's like the moon. As we say, the older the moon, the brighter it shines. Yeah, my man.
It's still shining today. Out of any band, without a doubt, your band has been heard by more than anyone in the whole festival here at Lollapalooza. Everyone knows your music. And I guarantee during your set, you're going to hear tens of thousands of people singing along with your music.
Give thanks and praise to the Most High, Lord God, the Rastafari.
Is there any particular moment that you remember of your personal time with Bob Marley that really stands out most in your mind out of any other moment?
Well, I'll tell you one where we were in Italy playing for about 260,000 people. And before, we were interviewed by journalists. And I recall they said to me, "What you guys think of the revolutionary? Are you guys not a scare?" I said, "No, we're not a scare." They said, "Why?" I said, "All the revolutionaries are our fans."
That's right. One of the moments that I remember most from Bob Marley and the Wailers is the One Love Peace Concert.
Yes.
In Jamaica, when you brought together the two opposing leaders.
Yeah. Position and opposition.
Right.
Yeah.
No matter if it was a very true sentiment between the two, they did come together with Bob standing in the middle, both hands almost with a triangle with Bob in the middle.
Yes.
Which was a very, very symbolic, very symbolic moment.
Here standing on the stage playing and was very
and George Bush. And but even worse with Michael Manley and Edward Siaga was like two dons of Jamaica.
Yes.
At that time, they ran. There were shootings and killings. But if you took, if you took George Bush, of our president, and you took Michael Moore or something like that, someone who hate one another and put them together like that.
Right. You have to know the true power in your music. But when you bring it together in front of a nation that was divided at the time, so much political unrest at that time, how did that personally feel to you standing on this stage?
It was a good feeling of knowing that we are trying to let the people come together, bring them all together, to know that how good and how pleasant it will be to see the unification of everyone. You know?
These lyrics you're bringing to me are just hitting right here. It's a it's a beautiful feeling. What was your favorite song that you had written?
Different from We Will Be Forever
right.
Loving
Jah. But different from that.
We love songs like Exodus.
Movement of Jah People.
Movement of Jah People. And Get Up and Stand Up and Fight for a Ride. And Who the Cap Fit.
Let Them Wear It.
Which is man to man. You know, like sure not your best friend could be your worst enemy. Or your worst enemy could be your best friend, you know? So we have to keep praying to the Almighty for health and strength, wisdom, knowledge, and overstanding. Not understanding, overstanding. Uh-huh. When you understand, you end up as a believer. And belief kills and it cures. But the greatest thing is to know. So when you know, then you overstand.
You have a lot of sayings that sort of twist words around to bring them to your message, right?
Yeah. I give you parables and then I interpret it.
Right. Are there any common misconceptions about Bob Marley and the Wailers that you hear all the time that, that's not right?
Well, what we do is bring in the prophet from the old age and what is to be in the fulfillment in this time.
Right.
We're working on a new album right now.
Yeah.
That is like the Santana Supernatural album, that concept. We're working on a new album that we're bringing all these new contemporary artists, all these different names, like all across the board from all different genres, to do new songs, new material with the whole original band. Even with his brother Carly, we have him on drums. Old 2-inch tapes we transferred to wave files, to Pro Tool files.
Wow.
And all these artists are gonna give their own vibe and play their own music. You know, like not their own music, but their own, like, you know, instruments and sing and add to it. And we've had every artist we've approached, they all are like been super, you know, inspired by the Wailers.
Absolutely.
And obviously their music and obviously. Family Man, the architect of all of it. Really, the musical director and the architect of all of the Bob Marley and the Wailers stuff. And reggae music. And it even goes further than reggae music. It goes into hip-hop and everything that we hear today, because all those people, that bass, that sound of the bass, that thickness that you hear in the clubs today, it's from this man right here. So look out for it next year, by hopefully, God willing, next year, this summer. It's in infant stages right now. I've approached a lot of friends of mine who are musicians. So every single one of them has said, yes, whatever you want to do.
Family Man, if you could pick anyone for this album, anyone, who would it be?
Well, of course, I would pick some of the name brands, the popular people, what everyone is listening to, especially the young people, for sure.
The foundation's going to be a reggae album. It's a roots. The roots will be the foundation, but they're going to bring their own elements to
okay.
it. A lot of them are playing here. It's going to be all across the board, a world thing.
That's some incredible news. How are you feeling about doing this sort of concept of album?
Yeah, man, it feels good. As a man could tell you, it was our hope for many years.
Man, and the time since Supernatural came out, I always had this idea, you know?
Basically got it from Supernatural.
Yeah,
right.
When Carlos did that album, I was like, man, this is what we need to do. The Wailers need to do it, coming out with an album with new material, but with collaborating with all these other artists.
Collaborate first, and then after that one, then we give you a full Wailers album after that.
When you do this album, you have to have a huge concert about this.
Oh, yeah.
You know that it would absolutely fill this whole park, right?
It'll be a TV special.
Yes, we're going to make sure to set it up just like when Michael was in the swing. I heard that there's a 45 release in Jamaica with Michael Jackson. But we work on his song, a record.
Really?
It's called My World.
So we have 1 minute left. I just want to say, my favorite song of all time is One Love, because One Love means more to me than any song I've ever heard on so many different levels.
Yeah, man, One Love is telling you about Jah love, you know? The almighty love, universal love.
Yeah.
Not like the I love you and you love me, global love.
But I've never heard it played live. Why?
You're going to hear it tonight.
I was just going to say, if you played One Love tonight, I'll be forever indebted to you, because I've never heard it. Honestly, I've never heard it, and I'm going to be right up front, sing along every single word. Family Man, thank you very, very much for your time. Much honor and much love to you and the rest of the family.
Yeah, man, and the Wailers say greetings to all the people of Chicago and America. And the globe.
Motrain's tracks. Music. Entertainment. Interviews. Parties. Be a part of the Motrain's tracks takeover. More information at themotrain.com.